Guys, just gonna continue on from last stream. I did some work off stream as well. Man, it's taking long. I hope I can make it on time because it's due tomorrow at I want to say 7 p.m. So, may have to do an overnight, I don't know. But we're gonna continue on. I did some digging for a bow. I'm not sure I should use a fancy bow just because it seals away the tension. Now I grabbed something like this, it might steal away the character, although it does highlight the class itself. Now I do have a second option. I grabbed something that's more low key. Something like this or like this will be low key to actually implement. We are gonna go. But I wanted to. I think I'm gonna go with this, and although I think it's gonna be it's too much of a eye catcher. May have to play around with the color combinations. Maybe black with like a silver, like this color here, so it doesn't steal too much. Maybe that's the key to that. And yeah, we'll go on from there. All right, let's see what I have. It should be good. I just have to do some. All right, let's get some little stuff out of the way. Make sure my live chat is done. Ooh, so many windows open. All right, let's start. So, I did a test run for the shading to blend with the atmosphere. Now it's gonna be something like this, but it might be more darker and dramatic. And same color as the background. I have to grab that color, but this was just a test run. But yeah, we'll go ahead and try to nail down the bow there. We'll just grab the color from these palettes. Okay, we'll do a separate layer. So we're gonna leave that bow right there so we can get an outlay of generally where the bow should be, kind of. So there should be a wheel here. We'll grab this color of the wheel. We'll lock the bow. Start plopping the where the bow should be. Strings around. I think we use a string from here. That's too thick. We're gonna pull back from that. Let's use about a 4, radius of 4, brush size 4, sorry. So we're going to point here and grab it from there. Now we do have to erase that part. I'll just do it now. May have to tone down the bow. Just make it visibility about 50. Lock it back. Okay, so it goes through here. We'll make that 90%. I feel like everything is kind of that same color. I'll make this gray here. Now, because she's not really pulling back too much, we have to plop out where the arrow should meet, where the bow should meet. Computer is just acting weird these days. So it's going upwards. So I think it'll help me. For orientation, I'll just rotate it. There we go. Should have done that beforehand. still goes on top of the arrow. So we've kind of got a diamond shape right here. So, second diamond shape. It's kind of off alignment. So now that happens when you're copying and then the perspective gets overlooked. One thing is like to envision it from far and then have like little landmark markers to help you guide you through it. Grab this gold here. It's funny. So this has like a lips on the top side, like and just goes up, and then this actually has a round bit instead, like that for the bottom. I guess if I'm like, it's very different when you create your own bow, because you can do the general, like, what's it called? Silhouette, and then put design on top of that. But here I'm copying, so it's a little bit harder when it comes to that. For me, anyways. Comes out around here. two tips ends around here. So something around here as well. Then folds up. Goes beyond the point of here. So a little kind of diamond comes out from there. All right, let's see if you curve it here. So this might have to move up. This will have to, I guess, contract a bit more. Maybe these are coming out too much. So, with that being done, that kind of took a while to map out. So what we can do is copy it, this side anyways. So we can use this format, just say control C and then control V, and we got ourselves another one. Just gotta flip it. So flip, So the orientation of this is going to be a little bit, I have to distort it a bit just because there's like foreshortening happening. Just go like that, and then like this. Just gonna have to move this. It's just a bit more. Redraw this part to maybe go like this. You know what? I should have done all the detailing and then transfer over. Copy and paste. Yeah, I should have done that. Actually, we can still do that. We're gonna go back to number 13, lock 14, and we'll start detailing it up. Middle and the one side there. Takes a lot of precision. What is this? Just delete it. So that ends right around here, the black parts. I gotta keep going back and see. Yeah. Sorry, it's got a little bit of bronze actually. Maybe you should put it bronze. Noises. Try to make the same color as theirs, actually. I think I just shade these parts before I add in these details. Might have to redraw it if I do that. I think I'll speed it up by just simply not using layers for the bow. I'll see if that speeds it up. I think I was too careful with always using layers, and that causes like the speed to suffer a little bit. You do save time sometimes. But I don't know if I did. That's the point. Okay, so some gold on here. I think this is gold right here. Can't see on the other side. Looks good. Keep going. I wonder if I should lay out all the flat colors first. Decisions. Now there's a potential of just tracing it, but I opted that out because I want to as much as I can to draw it by hand and copying instead. I find that this contest is kind of restricting a lot of ways. And I saw some of the recent submissions. It was I don't think I'm gonna win, honestly. I was like, some of the guys gone insane and just like really over the top. He's got skill. But I'm already working on it, so I'm just gonna submit it anyways. Because I never participated in any competition, at least want to do it once. It's quite crooked, isn't it? I think it's around here. I don't know why my monitor is flickering. I think it's like the cords are just... There you go. That looks more straight. Yeah, sometimes when you go into details, just you get lost in it and then you forget to check the perspective. I'm not gonna go in tight on the detailing just yet. Wanna get the right look first. In a way, I kind of have the same angle as that bow right there. Kind of similar when you, of course, flip it. So because you're seeing the ellipse this way, and then that's one, that means this should be going this way. Like either that or touch this part. So the yellow piece is not. Okay, there's some great thing about flat layers, you can do this. You can just rotate pieces. You cannot do it when it's in layers, and that's pretty much big problem sometimes. You would have to flatten it. Here goes the monitor. Here goes the monitor. I need a new wire. This goes like that. I have to get rid of this piece. I have to grab like this piece. And then it switches to gold. This bow is like thick. Let's grab this dark one. So this kind of overlaps the top here. Actually goes in. And then this black piece peeks out right here. Try to get some catch light, some highlights, sorry. And let's Sometimes I put that in, like, a lot of artists don't want to put it in until the final piece. It's because the reward. I like to put it in because that means I have all the palettes inside the piece. I can just grab quick eyedropper. Oh, hey, Lefty, how's it going? Thanks for the raid. How you been? You were streaming, right? What were you playing? Alright. Cool, cool. You taking a break now? Is it lunch or dinner? I'm good. Just trying to finish this piece before tomorrow. Oh, jeez. Dark Souls 3, are you getting ready for some Elden Ring? I sure is. Can't wait for that. I believe I was playing some Dark Souls 2 as well. Yeah. Yes, it's kind of relaxing for some people to just watch as the art progresses. It's kind of peaceful when I do it. Too. There are some stressful moments. Yeah, one of my buddies told me he won't allow me to play Elden Ring until I beat Dark Souls 3. I mean, it's not required, but it'll sure make you better at Elden, maybe. I'm sure there's going to be some differences. Hey, what's up, Fate? Yeah, welcome to the channel. I forgot to introduce. This channel is the Mansion Lion, and I do art. And today I am continuing drawing Final Fantasy art. This is the piece so far. Put it that way. Yeah, so it's kind of coming, it's getting there. I can show you kind of the outtake of what it was at first. Brush, you forgot who I was. Brah. Yeah, please remind me. For the teddy, you bidding 5 teddies for the bees. Sorry, I forgot. How'd that work out? So I'll just show you from the beginning. Oh my god. I think my wire's like busted or something. Monitor keeps flicking. So it started with this and changed the color, added the moon, and then the guys, and then the foreground, and then the character. It's all right. I kind of like the detail it has now, especially her armor. Yeah. If I let's put away the bow, you can see the armor now up close. So this is at 100%. So I had to move her down a little bit because of the perspective. I had to cut her feet a little bit more. So yeah, this is where we're at now. Last stream you had that I was watching, you were still refining some stuff in her body. Yeah, yeah. I was doing her, was it bracelet or what do you call it, gauntlets? I don't know which video you're watching, but I hadn't finished her leg, this piece, and the little, I don't know, drapery around here. So that had to be fixed. Today I just finished all of that, and we're doing the final piece for her, the bow. So I was on the fence rather just to keep this bow. It looks kind of plain towards her armor, so, but also didn't want like a bow to, you know, steal the spotlight. So I was debating about that, but I did decide like, it does, you know, portray her class. So I went with that bow. So I do have the other bow still underneath just to give us a guideline of where it's supposed to land. Oh, I did experimenting with the shading because she's so bright against the background. Eventually it'll be toned down a little more like that. We'll bring her out for more, but I'll have to experiment with that layer. But for now, we'll just leave her as this first. And then, yeah, we're just working away on the bow here. Man, I think after when Elden Ring launches, I kind of want to do like a lot of art piece on this, on that game. The only problem is I probably can't sell it on merch. I'll have to do like my own version. find copying is kind of like a hassle. You have to be precise on the design. Hey, Savvy. How's it going? Just chilling. Yeah, so I decided to stream early these days just because. Suddenly there's like static. I got some echoing. There we go. I was wondering what that was. Then get this at 20%. Grab something brighter. Oops. Let's try to get that in here. So if you were to play Elden Ring, from what you saw, I kind of want to know what everyone's weapon, what choice of weapon would be. Cause I was like, maybe curved sword. But then I saw the twin blade, and I'm like, okay, twin blade. I'm mostly a halberd kind of guy. Prefer the bow. That's like playing first person shooter. Yeah, they should give you that option to change to first person if people want. If they're gonna play like bow. And then, what if they add like cool animation when you're shooting the bow? That'd be kind of cool. Kind of like what Monster Hunter World had. I think that would be kind of OP though. They'll have to balance it. You know, at first when I was starting to stream the art stream, I wasn't sure, 'cause like I think a lot of artists feel the same way when they like start to show their stuff. It's like, oh, I'm not worthy. And then I think you just get used to it. You kind of have to get out there anyways. There are some people I've met, like, you know, who does art and then they're very good, but they're like, oh, they're just like hobbyists and they're like not serious. I was like, well, what a shame. I wish I had your skill. Okay, we're getting to the middle, the tricky part. Okay, so on the corner, it goes like that. I mean, beside like Elden Ring, I think there's Forbidden West, Dying Light 2 or something. It's coming this year. I was actually looking at Babylon 2 as well. I wasn't sure if that's any good. I saw some gameplay. You know what I want to see from software? I want them to make Armored Core again. 'Cause that's actually the their f starter project. That game wasn't easy to play too. Okay. I think that dot is too big. Oh, I did see some footage on Elden Ring where people are using like shields and shit to attack instead. That looked kind of trippy. I'm trying to be like Captain America. I think some weapons need a little bit more care. Like, I think the whip needs to be done better. Like, fancier move or something like that. Yeah, I think if you play like compare Demon Souls and Dark Souls 3 especially, the fighting is kind of a little bit more different. I mean, Demon Souls was kind of the first installment. That's why the bosses weren't as epic as number 3. And the movesets is better at the at on DS3. So the light is actually right around here. Music kind of shut off. get in there. Can't grab that color. Okay, there's something wrong with perspective here. So I was just doing flat, so we're gonna have to change the dynamic here. I'm gonna take this. I think this door might work. Yeah, something like that. So pretty much there's foreshortening on the bow, so because the opening is right here, so this would be facing this way actually. Something like that. I gotta look at the bow again. So this part actually comes out a bit. That's why it is having some kind of indent line there. And it is attaching to this. So I'm gonna have to back out and see the navigation to this. And just try to get the perspective right. Okay. Hey, Halas, thanks for lurking. Not creepy at all. It's okay, I lurk too. Kind of a simple design there. It's just like a square. Okay, it's just like a toast or something. Ooh. You know what? I'm just gonna make it black. Harder to make the four squares. And then just draw it on. Kind of a missed opportunity. They just had that crosshatch thing instead. It's supposed to be that circle thing. Let's put it right here, actually. We won't go in detail for that. We'll just keep going. It's bottom. And we're gonna do some detailing here. I have to get in close though for that detail. Okay, I'll grab something. It's almost time to do the cheat. The great thing about digital is you can, there's a lot of shortcuts to take. You should definitely take it. As I'm running out of time. I've been sitting at this desk for a while now. So now I'm trying to stream, at least try to stream at 7 Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Sometimes I start early, like 6. But I don't want to pressure myself to absolutely at 6, so I put 7 as my regular, but sometimes you can see me at 6. This square is so detailed. It's like, what about the rest? Okay, it's gonna step away from that square. It's like, I have to make that perfect square. Okay. There was something right there. Erase this part. So we're gonna try to cheat a little bit. So since we have the first half of the bow, we're gonna delete this. So we're gonna just copy it again. Huh? That's not the right one. All right, so we got this duplication, and we just need to flip it. We actually don't need the centerpiece. We'll just cut it out right there. Okay, now this is like the Photoshop hacks. Transform and distort. You see how that's like making a depth? It's definitely around here. That looks good. Drop it. Then I'll fix the rest with the drawing. We will fix the wheel just a bit. It got distorted a lot. So now that the arrows, the bow's kind of plotted, we can get rid of the bottom bow. It's this layer here. Okay, now that we have the both sides, I have to fix it though. I'm gonna merge the two layers. Oops, went outside. Hey, it's a potent toast. What's up? How's your day been? some fancy bow. Yeah, had to work. In a way, I'm working too. I feel ya. It's crunch time, so time's almost up for me. Need a break soon. Yeah, only took me 2 hours. It's not quite done, but it's good progress, I guess. I should erase this part. Only 2 hours? Yeah, only 2 hours. For a bow. 2 hours for a bow. I think I'm gonna transition to more of a painter, because I don't like spending too much time on details. I think I learned more if I just hammer out the art using suggestive paints. I forgot the arrow. Let's bring back the bow. Let's just unlock this layer. So I just bring back the bow. So I just want the arrow part this time. Call it real bow, and then I'll bring this bow up forward. So we're just gonna delete this bow. We only want to keep the arrow. I gotta look at that picture reference. How's that bow go? So it does go on it, on the other side. It looks kind of weird that it does. We will... real bow. Actually, let's just name this arrow. Is that a specific item for the game or made up bow? No, I used the reference. Yeah, there's a reference here. I wasn't sure if I should use some fancy bow. It'll steal away the character. But the, what's it? Competition says you have to display the class. The class is signified by what weapon, so. So I decided to go for it. And not sure if it's straight. Okay, let's plop it down and we'll use some kind of thing to help us. Yeah, that weapon is perfect. Yeah, those other ones that look like ridiculous, and it's just like, I don't think it matches. So this one, yeah, pretty much matches. It has black and gold, so I decided this one would do it justice. Let's see here. So we're just gonna use this reference point and see if it aligns. Kind of does. Yeah, kind of does. So we just use that and then just, actually we'll have to drive one. That's kind of bizarre when it goes through the weapon there, so I'm just going to put it behind anyways, even though that's not particularly how they would hold it, given the position that she's in. That looks better, even though, like, you know, if it's for real, the arrow would go on this side. Although the arrow is not the same. Everyone's different though, like some archery people actually put it on the opposite way, what we're taught. So we just make this attach. Now this kind of looks warped, so I have to fix this for sure. But it does help me with the perspective. No, but if you're looking at this girl here. Oops. See the part you hold the arrow, the bow? The arrow is supposed to go on the other side. This is the notching arrow. Oh, I'm just looking at her arrowhead. Her arrowhead's like that. Let's just leave this arrowhead. Who cares? Yeah. Sometimes I think we're taught the wrong way, actually. It's supposed to be on the other side. It makes it faster. But in design wise, this makes more sense because it's covering the arrow. The bow, sorry. Man, okay. So I like the results. Let's put that away. Come on, I need a new wire. That is dying. Let's just make that rope attached more. So I wonder if I can, distort it back instead of drawing it. Yeah, I'll see ya. I'm gonna have to take a break soon. And I'll come and raid ya. So it's facing the other way. We're gonna have to switch the lighting around. This is the light side, and that's the dark side. And because it's facing the other way, it'll show less of this side. And we're talking about lights. It's right here. Always have to be conscious of where the light goes. So that's there. All right, it's almost that time where I'm going to take a break. I'll go raid my buddy, Spontos. He plays AOE4. If you want to subscribe to him, love that RTS. He's your man. Yes, there's this little warping here going on. I'm gonna fix that. So this is the peak of that side. Alright, I'm gonna go raid my buddy. Hope you guys enjoy this. This is pretty cool. I guess it was kind of fast too, because I kind of cheated. Copied it and pasted it. And now I'm on the other side. Would have taken longer, I think. Yeah. All right. Save this. Let's show some love to my buddy. What's up?
Hey, what's up?
I think I'm gonna sit this one out. I've been at the desk for a while.
Okay. Sounds good.
I have
a
Yep.
Trying to do the whistling arrows one. I swear that's the hardest achievement for any of the Sims. But I was just thinking of getting one button.
There's plenty of villagers to kick.
They kill 50. They kill 50 with 60 arrows.
Uh-huh.
It's not gonna be easy.
Oh. So you're not showing the cartoon guy?
Oh yeah, I forgot my avatar today.
Yeah, something about it says graphic card not captured or something. Could be that.
Yeah. Thanks for letting me know.
Mm-hmm.
Well, here I am.
I'm gonna do some stretch.